You've heard us talk a lot about our fourth member. We say the New Day doesn't have three members. The New Day has four members. Go ahead, throw them up if you can see this. If they use this for socials, we got bent fingers. Mm-hmm. The fourth member of the New Day is here, ladies and gentlemen. And his name is Michael Notarelli.
All right. I like that intro. I like that intro.
Without this man, New Day does not exist. He always says, no, it's all of us. Without this man,
tell him now.
We don't
now.
Get together. Without this man fighting for us every single day, going to bat for us, making sure that our ideas are being heard, making sure that our emotions are being expressed, making sure that we have a fighting chance in this industry called professional wrestling. Yes, it is professional wrestling. That's what it is. We are professional wrestlers, and this man did everything within his power to make sure we had the chance to express ourselves in the way that we wanted. Thank you, Michael. Thank you, Michael Notarelli.
Yes, preach it, brother.
Thank you for that intro. I honestly think I got to invite you guys to my wedding and give me that intro before I just come out down the aisle.
You know we there.
Mike was a writer for WWE. He was fighting the good fight for many a talent. I would say for many an underutilized talent. You were often the go-to for guys who were trying to reboot themselves or get off the ground. And I think you started working with Woodsy in 2014. And this was maybe even earlier. But anyways, we got together as a collective around 2014. And you were our entry in. You were the man who knocked down those doors. It's crazy, and this is a longer conversation, but it's crazy how many people, how many talent don't really truly understand the creative process. They don't hear the feedback that they could probably benefit from. And you really schooled us. You put your boys on game. You put us up on game. You taught us, and you were there. As it was so collaborative. And that's why you truly are the fourth member of the New Day, because we don't ever get on TV without you. Not only did you allow us to understand the creative process, but you were in there truly fighting for us. And there is 100% chance, I'm phrasing this oddly, but there's 100% chance that New Day never makes TV without you. So you.
Well, I appreciate that. You guys, obviously, you I think you carried more of the weight because you had to deliver on all of that stuff. But also, you made it fun for me going into pre-tapes with you guys and bugging Brawler and, you know, and making pre-tapes. Like, it was fun. It was something to look forward to. So it wasn't, you know, as I appreciate all of that, but it was also like selfishly, it was just fun for me to do that stuff and to work with you guys and all that.
And I think the thing that really helped us the most with that, the things that you were explaining to us and just the ways that everything worked, because to us, it was like, okay, cool. Like, we have an idea for a group. We're not really sure what it's going to be or what we want it to be. And we're molding it and figuring it out. And we were just thinking like, okay, we have to figure out how this works as a group. And then when you were able to break it down, like, okay, well, we're not getting through with that message. What if we get these Lego pieces together first? And then add this Lego piece, and then add this one, and then before anybody even realizes it, you're already a group, so we're good at that point. And it's like, that's a completely different way to attack, to try to get what we want, and it ended up working. And again, like he said, like 100% chance that New Day doesn't happen unless you come to us and explain that like very logistical plan of attack to us.
But you guys were also willing to accept that, and without naming names, there were other talent that I would get this. I would get whatever version of an idea they want on. I would be this close to getting it on TV. And then you could backfill, like you're saying, later. And they can only see the one version they had in their head and it never got on TV because they weren't moldable the way that you guys were. And by the way, Vince threw something, a curveball your way, and you guys made the best of it too. So I think, you know, we got on the field and I helped you guys get on the field, but you guys were able to hit curveballs and curveballs and curveballs and curveballs. And that's really the reason for your success.
Yeah. I think it also too, like for us, it came from like a place of desperation, at least for me. Like I felt, we've talked about this many times. I felt like if this doesn't go well, then I'm gone or I'm sent back down to NXT or like, you, it just feels like this is it. This is the last big pitch. So it felt like all my chips have to be in on this. I have to give you my trust. I have to like listen to, because you knew so much more than I did at the time, especially about how things work or the best way to put this thing together. And I think instantly it all just felt right with when Woods first came to me, and then we worked with you, and then with Kofi, it felt like okay, these are the four men that should be working on this together. And it just felt like all the pieces were where they needed to be. And like, I didn't know what incarnation or how long the group would last. Like, getting 6 months of a faction would have been great. Like, if you told me, hey, you'll be on TV for 6 months, I'd have been like, I'm sold. And the fact that we're 6 years in and still going.
Amazing. It's a testament to your guys' talent. And all I can say is just, after all those trials and tribulations, like, thank God I was able to leave where you guys were the tag team champions. And that was my last weekend there, my last week there, because had I left anything on the table, I would always regret, oh man, what if I stayed, or what if, but I was able to bring you to a certain part of the field and leave, and sort of leave on in good faith that, oh, they can, they'll take the ball 90 yards, you know, and go down the rest of the field.
And it was obviously, like, because we really developed a real friendship, and it was hard to see you walk away. But I remember, like, we talked about this, is one of the things that we discussed. And there was like some talk about, hey, you know, why don't you stay around for a bit and stick it out and stay with us? But then I remember something, I don't know why it came to mind, but some absurd reference about a baby bird.
Is that absurd?
How you were the mama bird.
I'm going to go on my gravestone. Dude, you know how Michael Jordan had that song, like, before a game, that, like, this song that would always play and get everyone hyped?
Yeah.
Before I have a pitch for a movie or a TV, I just think about that baby bird promo. And I'm like, wow, man, I got to make him proud. It's no joke back here. Basically, you want to tell the gist of it?
Well, yeah. I mean, my memory's horrible, but let me know if I miss it.
I don't know the specifics, but I do know that obviously, you know, Woods had every right, as you guys are saying, the four of us, you know, perfect unit. We served our roles perfectly, and it was just like a well-moving train. You guys became tag team champions. This is it. This is all we worked for a year and a half, right? Woods, of course, as he should be, was a little worried, like, why are you leaving us now, right? It's a little bit like, why would you go now? And And I was, you know, feeling regret. I'm a guilty Italian guy, man. I'm always going to feel guilty. I'm going to feel regret. But I had other dreams in my end, writing for TV and stuff. And Woods was expressing some of his worry about me leaving and his anxiety. And Big E, man, cut one of the best promos ever, right outside of male talent, by the way. So people are going in and out, in and out, in and out. Woods is jokingly, but also kind of seriously, like, I'm worried you're going to go and what's going to happen. And Big E pulls from the depths of his soul and cuts this promo about me being Mama Bird chewing the food for you guys and spitting it into your mouth, and how now you guys are going to chew on your own and digest your own food, and by God, Mama Bird's going to let baby birds fly on their own, and all this stuff. And I'm sitting there, like, people are bumping into me. The Usos are like, what are you doing standing in the doorway? And I'm sitting here going, oh my God, like, I can't let them down now. Mama Bird and Baby, they got to play. Everyone's going to fly.
Do you want more?
Of course you do. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts and feel the power.